Welcome to Enroll to Join Us. We're going to start the first hour, as you'll see on your agenda, with all Cedar Valley representatives from different parts of the college so that you can ask your questions and learn a little bit about what you'll have access to next year as you transition from the high school campus to the college campus. Each speaker will be speaking about 10 minutes or less. So if you have questions during the presentation, go ahead and raise your hand. We are live streaming because we have other high schools and early colleges participating via the web. So we will be getting some questions perhaps from Ms. Jaleesa Belam, who's right here in the polka dots. She's part of my staff. And I'm Olivia Guerra, and I'm the director of the Early Collegiate Discovery Center, which houses the early college high schools and dual credit. So thank you again for being here this evening. Please ask questions if you have them. And without further ado, we're going to bring up our very first speaker, Commander Williams.
Hey, thank you so much for being here. I'll try to be as brief as possible. I know a lot of people get nervous when the law enforcement's using it around, but once I finish my presentation, I'm gonna show you something a little bit different that I think you'll appreciate. One of the things that I did when I became chief here after serving more than 30 years with the Dallas Police Department is to understand or try to better understand how we can align ourselves with the success, the missions and the goals of the students, not only just the traditional students here, but the early college high school students here as well. So as a college professor, and I'm a college professor as well, I actually did a study called The Challenges of Early College High School Students on College Campuses. And so one of the things I wanted to look at is what were some of the truths associated with having early college high school students on college campuses. So I had an opportunity not only to interview Olivia and her staff, but I also had an opportunity to speak with the school administrators, as well as law enforcement officers, and as well as the students themselves to get a better understanding about the program. And with that being said, it gave me an opportunity to create a roadmap, not only for myself, but for my officers as well, on how we were going to police or provide police service to these young men and these young women. So one of the things, and I'll be in Austin this week actually talking about this presentation. It lasts about an hour, but I'm going to give you about a 5-minute version before bringing up my chaplain. And this particular presentation actually benefits our counselors, our law enforcement officers, faculty, as well as students, okay? So there's many burning questions when it comes to law enforcement officers. How do I handle a high school student on a college campus? Whose rules or jurisdictions do they actually fall under? Okay, is it a co-jurisdiction with other law enforcement agencies, with the ISD, or do they fall under the college jurisdiction and we handle them appropriately under the college jurisdiction? And so with that being said, there's a lot of questions not only here in Dallas, but throughout law enforcement. And I think this particular presentation answers a lot of those particular questions. Now, it creates a gray area for us, because we're talking about a hybrid student, so to speak. So your students today are like a hybrid student, the ones between college as well as high school. We know that we've got 41 in Texas, new high schools for the academic year, with 17 being in Dallas and one across the street at Lancaster. And it just kind of gives you some idea of the new schools that we have here and actually where they're going throughout the district. Now, from the law enforcement standpoint, one of the things that I preach, you hear about it, one of the things that I preach, model, and example is the fact that we are a community-oriented police department, okay? That's what the community wants. That's what we give you. But what do you mean, Chief, when you say a community-oriented police department? Like I said, I'm a college professor as well. I have kids as well. And so one of the requirements of my officers is you treat these children that come to school here like you treat your own children, okay? And so they start building relationships with the children. I try to tell all of my early college high school students, do not be surprised if one of my officers stop you and ask you about your homework. Why is that? Why do you think they do that? Number one, engagement. Number two, they're building a relationship. Number three, they really want to help you with your homework. All of my officers have degrees, and I tell them to utilize it. utilizing with the students here on campus. And so I want them to be the difference in your lives, because we are here, listen to me, parents, we're here to educate our kids, not write citations and arrest them. We're here to educate the students. And that's part of the process that I ask my office to serve in as well. We serve them up what we call a piece of the pie. Number one, we provide them with personalized policing. They can come to us and talk to us about anything, okay? We identify what social issues they're having. Yes, problems that you're having, kids, even at home. Can I come talk to you, Chief Williams, for a minute? Absolutely. Chief, can I talk to you about some more students over here at the school? Absolutely. So these are social issues that we discuss with, we establish ourselves as stakeholders. And here's an important key. We want to connect the dots. We want to connect the dots between compassion, you hear what I said? Between compassion, community, and common sense. Okay? We want to connect the dots between compassion, community, and common sense. And that's why when you see me in my department, I always have a chaplain with me as well. Okay? Some of the things that we kind of do, and Vidya, she's here, she'll tell you one of the things our students talk about is how stressed out they are sometimes. Okay? Come to the police department. We can help with that. What do we do? We actually bring therapy dogs here on campus for our students during testing periods and all that. So kids, when you see these dogs on campus, they're not dope sniffing dogs, okay? They're here for you, for your benefit. They're here for therapy, okay? And so in order to protect and educate, I'm not gonna go through all of these. These are just a list of things that our officers actually cover, okay? Remember here, you come here to obtain a degree, a college degree, not a criminal record. And that's important, and I emphasize that with my officers. When you see my officers engage with you, I use what I call the 25% rule that I introduce them. I want them to be 25% educator, 25% mentor, 25% counselor, as well as 25% law enforcement officer. And they can be wearing that hat at any time. But I remind my officers, just because you're 25% law enforcement, doesn't mean you can't be 75% of everything else, okay? And so with that being said, just quickly, I want to introduce one of my main chaplains here, and that's, Dr. James Bradley, but James Bradley, one of my chaplains. Come on up, James.
There you go. As he mentioned, thanks for coming out. We really want to help you all to understand that we care about your students here. And he said there were three C's. Anybody remember? Community, compassion, and common sense. Very good. Okay, how many of you have cell phones? Students, how many of you students have cell phones, right? And how many of you have ever had your cell phone taken by your parents? Anybody? Okay, how many of you have ever skipped class? Okay, you probably don't want to show me, right? Okay, here's the reason I asked that. Because we want to link community, compassion, and common sense, you're doing those things to get your phone taken, you're doing those things skipping class because something is going on with you. And we want to help you to understand you got to use common sense. And so when you are struggling with something, you can come and talk to me. I'm a chaplain. I can help you from a counseling perspective. Let me tell you something else about common sense. When you come on this college campus, you're going to think you have some whole, you know, a lot of new freedoms and that kind of thing, and you will have some new freedoms. But you got to use common sense, otherwise those freedoms that you might have elsewhere could get you into some serious trouble on this college campus. How many of you like the opposite sex? How many of you like boys? How many of you like girls? That is, you want a boyfriend or you want a girlfriend, right? How many of you? Raise your hand. Oh, you don't want to show me with your parents. I understand that. Okay, but watch this. You get a boyfriend or a girlfriend on this college campus, and you could actually have a boyfriend or a girlfriend who is an adult. Now can you see how that's not using common sense? Can you see how you could get yourself into some serious trouble? Parents, can you understand that?
Yes.
That's the other reason we are here. That's the other reason they are here. To help your children be safe. That's all I got. When y'all get here, come see me. Right?
Yes.
And I'm going to show you how common sense can help keep you out of trouble. God bless you.
And so in closing this, you know, just like Cedric the Entertainer said on his commercial, students, we hear you. I promise you that we hear you. We even listen to your voices. You tell us, Chief, I'm worried about this open environment with weapons on campus, this concealed carry, the smoking. And for some parents, kids have actually come and talked to us about older men. And so, of course, I was kind of disturbed by that. I said, older men, what are these older men doing? They said, well, they're trying to talk to us. And so, of course, I'm thinking, college professors trying to talk to high school students? And they went, no, you know, the other older men, the traditional students. I said, well, how old are they? They said, oh, 19 and 20. And so we have to deal with those. And that's a real issue to our students. And so we have to deal with that. Because remember now, when these students show up at early college high school, guess what? A lot of you guys in here, you've been freshmen before, right, in college. And how do we see that? Oh, we got new girls on campus. We got new guys on campus. But the things that we do to remind our students, and then the engagement portion, hey, look, there's a difference between your age, even though they're here for a college degree, and your age as a traditional student. Be careful, because the law recognizes that. Okay? So we deal with those issues. Now, let me tell you how many early college high school students have been arrested in the 2 years that I've been here. Okay? You ready? Zero. Zero. Let me tell you how many's been detained. One. How many's arrested? Zero. But that detention did what? Got his attention. Okay? And so he was detained, but he was not arrested. But his parents were called. Because what did Chief Williams say at the very beginning? I don't believe in giving kids criminal records. I believe in giving them college degrees. And that's what I want to assist in doing. So we understand, kids, everything that you guys have talked about, that they shared this research with me. Like the chaplain said, Chaplain Bradley said, sometimes you bring to college, look, high school pranks, we're aware of that, okay? And we deal with that on our community policing level. Then again, we're sensitive to about relationships that you try to build, but most importantly, we want to focus on your academic responsibility, okay? So with that being said, that's the end of my presentation. Do I have any questions right quick before I leave? Questions? I guess I did pretty good.
Thank you.
All right, thank you. Thank you. Escort services are always available to every student on this campus. They'll get the emergency information on how to get in contact with us, or if not, my door is always open to students, always, okay?
Just want to make sure they can be safe when they call.
Yes.
Oh, absolutely, yes, sir, yes, sir. And I'll have them call you when they make it to their car with us. And, but you know that's a paid fee, right?
Thank you. Okay, there's some seats up here in the front. I know it's like
thank you,
church. Come on, y'all. And if you all in the back, if there's any seats between you, if you could squish in to make room on the ends. Okay, next up is our college nurse, Miss Mari Brock. Where is she?
Okay, good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I'm having a hard time projecting my voice, so I'm not going to talk very long or I'll start panting. So I just wanted to let you know that your ISD nurses and the college nurse here, my name is Mari Broad, will be working together to help take care of the early college high school students. And my office or the help center is located in Building A, and I help to do first aid and emergency. So if any of you young people get rambunctious and try to play in the cactus bed and happen to fall in the cactus and have needles stuck in your bed, you can come to the help center and I'll help pluck them out. That has happened. believe it or not, and it has happened. And a lot of other things have happened too, that when they come and call the college nurse. Sometimes, you know, you might just want to come into the help center and talk to the nurse when you're not comfortable talking to a counselor or anybody else, and I'm there to help. My background is mostly intensive care, and so I've been a nurse for many, many years. I'm not going to tell you how long, but my hair is gray. And I also help when they have their senior capstone projects, and they want to know more about help and good help skill. I help them with their projects and become a mentor to them so that their senior projects will be a success. And what else should I talk about other than, you know, trying to work with the high school nurse?
So later on, for those that are in here from Carter, your area will discuss just specific to Carter that there will be an assistant available to DISD students that will be housed in our area. But for emergency situations, or if you, like she said, you want to go talk to the college nurse, you may also drop in to see Mari, and she is in the A building. And there's a question right there.
Can you tell me about the new judge? Is that required for next year?
It is.
It is, yes.
So the question, for those of you who couldn't hear, was about the meningitis shot. That is a state requirement. That's not a Cedar Valley requirement. If you're going to go to any college campus, you're required to have the meningitis shot. It's good for 5 years from the date of administration, and you have to have it administered a minimum of 10 days prior to the first day of class, or they won't let you on campus. And that's to keep other students safe. Now, if you're over a certain age, but none of you are, you're exempt from it, but all of you have to have it.
And it's very, very important to have that meningitis vaccination, because I had a family member that was married into the family. He was young, but some of you young people might think he's old. He was 25 years old, and he contracted bacterial meningitis while being a shrimper coming in to the dock, and he had a high fever. They didn't know what was going on. Within a few hours, he started convulsing. He lost consciousness. In 24 hours, he was dead. So it is very, very important for you to get the meningitis vaccination. I can't stress it enough. Some people think, oh, it's just nothing. But people die from it, and they also have limbs amputated, arms amputated, legs amputated, and it's a very serious disease when you get it.
Okay. If there's no other questions, all right, thank you, Mari.
Thank you.
Okay, so once again, if there's a seat open on either side of you, I'm going to ask that you squish into the middle and open up seats on the end. We still have two up here, another one here that you can sit in. And also, we are live streaming this. So on top of your agenda is the link to where you can watch it as well. If you have to leave for any reason, it will be, it's being live streamed right now. You can ask questions, and you can also view it at a later time. Okay, now we're moving on to our academic support and engagement that's available to you as students. Next up, the illustrious Mr. Joel Colbert over our tutoring center.
First, let me say good evening.
Good evening.
And I am so excited about what's happening now, because I, along with the Carter staff, is directly responsible for the Carter Collegiate High School, and so I'm very proud of that. What I'll do is give you a brief overview of the services. I'm the managing director of the Student Academic Success Center, which undergirds all of instruction. And my number one goal is to ensure that your child walks out of Cedar Valley College with a workforce certificate, an associate's degree or be prepared to transfer to the university or college of their choice. That's my number one job, to move students from dependent to independent learning. Our goal is excellence, and we want every student that walks into Cedar Valley College to be able to compete academically at the highest level. And so now that I've said that, we're located in C206. We undergird instruction, and we have about three labs on campus. We have the main lab, which is in C206, which is the hub. We have the MRC, which is the Math Resource Center. And then we have tutoring going on in every location on this campus. There is some form of tutoring. I also teach integrated reading and writing and teacher preparation for those who may be interested in a career in teaching. What I've done is created a handout. You can pick this up. We are open this summer, Monday through Friday from 10 to 5. This is the fall and spring schedule. There are several ways that you can receive tutoring services. You can make an appointment, or you can visit online, or you can walk in. We prefer that you make an appointment so that when you make the appointment, you're guaranteed to work with the tutor at that time. If you walk in, you may have to wait. We do have an area, the service is free, there is no charge, and then we probably employ the most workers on this campus. If you make an ARB in the course after the semester, if you're old enough, you may be able to work with me. And so just keep that in the back of your mind. But if you like, you can take one of the handouts, and if there are any questions, I'll be happy to answer.
This is their website with the hours and where you can go on to go online tutoring. No questions? Y'all are a quiet group. Okay. Well, thank you, Joe. I know some of y'all have seen him before because he also does the TSI boot camps. And I just want to brag on Carter for a minute. Where are you, Ms. Baker?
Oh, yeah.
Can you tell us the percentage of students that were met that are 10th graders?
Please tell us.
My class of 2020 with lighting 100%.
Yeah.
My class of 2020 reading 95%.
Yes.
And with mathematics, we'll
We want another 100%. Okay. All right. Next up, we had a question. I'm sorry. You can't see it? Can you read it, Joe?
The times in the summertime, May 9th and summer 1 and summer 2, Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. During the long semester, it's different. We stay over two nights a week till 8, so that we can service night students as well. So we open up at 8 o'clock, and we all open on Saturday in the fall.
Saturday. Did you hear that? Saturday. They're open on Saturday. Okay.
Oh, the sheets are,
can you grab them? Yeah. Okay, next up from our library, we have beautiful Miss Vidya
Krishnaswamy. Okay, I'm really soft spoken. You know, I work in the library, so I'm soft. So if you can hear me, just ask the question again. And what I'm going to tell you is the library is located in the C building in C104. We are open in fall and spring for 64 hours, that includes Saturday. So we are open Monday through Thursday from 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. And we have different zones in the library, and we want the students to follow the rules that are posted in each zone. So silent study area, students need to be quiet, really quiet when they work. So there are groups. stones and someone's where they can sit together and do group work. And we also have group study rooms. They need their college ID to check out the group study rooms and work in the group study rooms. And there are about 40 computers that are available in the silent study area. That means if they are working in that area, they need to be really quiet. If they don't follow the rules, then they are going to lose the privileges of using the computer. And the computers need to be used for academic purposes only. No watching YouTube, no playing games. These computers are purely for academic use. I can't stress that enough. And we assist them with their research paper. We tell them how to find the search term with citation and how to use the electronic resources that's available on the library website. And these are the different ways to reach us. You can call, text, email, or tweet us, and we'll answer the questions. And students are allowed to borrow up to 10 books for 3 weeks from the library.
10 books, 3 weeks.
And if the book is not available in the CBC library, we can request it through intercampus loan from the rest of the campuses in the DCC library system. Have any questions?
Questions? I just want to reiterate, students, I know a lot of you, later on we're going to have a faculty member talk to you, but the library is full of resources beyond just your traditional books. So if you ever need help with a paper, finding something that you're having a hard time finding a reliable resource for, not Wikipedia, okay? You can't use Wikipedia, can't just Google things. But if you need academic journals, you need reliable resources, you're not sure how to find what you need, I'm going to tell you, we have the most amazing library staff. They're also a lot of fun. Like, everybody thinks, oh, library, boring, they're just quiet. They are so fun, and they have a lot of fun activities in the library. There's competitions with edible books. So you can like build a book title, they then eat cake afterwards. I mean, it's really fun. We had zombies, like if you touch somebody or doing a scavenger hunt. And there's really good prizes. So I just want you guys to like think a little bit outside of what you think of a library being and check in there and see what, you know, there's a lot of interesting things in there that can help you out.
And I want to say we have a 3D printer, and you can print 3D stuff if you want. And we have therapy dogs before the exam in the library, so you can come. And we have tons of resources. They're always there to help you be successful in your academics.
Thank you, Vidya. Okay. And again, I just want to remind students, if you have group projects and all of our collaboration stations are taken in B116, there are collaboration areas in the library as well that I've even used for meetings. So, love Netflix. Okay, next up is our fun Miyoshi Homes with the Office of Student Life, which is all the clubs and organizations that you are eligible to be a part of. Yay. Woo!
So you're hired. I was like, good. All right. While she's looking up the presentation that I want to show you, we'll give you a little idea of the reason why we're here. Okay. The reason why we have student life on campus is to make sure that while you are not in your academic classes, you are getting information that you can have for the rest of your life. How many of y'all get real bored really quick? I do. Really? Just a few of y'all? Be honest. How many of y'all get bored really easily? Yeah, that's about right. That's about right. So my job is to make sure that while you're on campus, you're getting some extra and co-curricular activities. Those of you who are in sports and music and those types of things, you know those are extra and co-curricular activities. But here on campus, my job is to make sure that I keep those busy hands busy while you're in between classes, okay? I'm going to make sure that when you have...
It died. Commander killed it.
Okay, that's
okay. I can click it.
All right, there's three reasons why you should be involved on campus. Number one is to make sure that when you graduate with soft skills that will get you jobs when you leave here. That's my job to make sure that happens. Please go back, go back, go back. Second of all, those of you who are participating in extracurricular activities have a better GPA. Isn't that crazy? Yes. Why do you think you'll have a better GPA if you participate in clubs and organizations and extracurricular activities? Why do you think? Just throw it out there. Anything that pops in your head. Why do you think that is? Thank you. You work harder, number one, and you keep your grades up to participate. And number three, because you're around people of like minds and they can help you study. Go figure that, right? So the busier you are, the more you have to attempt to get better grades. And then the last thing we help you do when you leave here is to graduate on time. How many of y'all are excited about doing your junior and senior year and your freshman and sophomore year at the same time? Woo! Not everybody can do that. Y'all are special. Well, I'm like, I wish they were having that when I was back, right? Okay. So, we're going to make sure that while you're here, you do all those things. The biggest thing that bothers me is at graduation time, when I'm sitting there and I'm helping the students get ready for graduation, and they tell me, are you trying to tell me that we had all these clubs and organizations on campus? I'm like, yes. Are you trying to tell me that all these people at graduation wearing all that bling came from your area? And I'm like,
yes, they did.
Okay. I have sent students on multiple trips to states. I have sent students to Austria. I have sent students to other countries by being a part of extra and co-curricular activities. So who doesn't want to be part of that, right? Don't you want to go out of the country? Don't you want new experiences? That's my job to make sure that happens for you. So we're going to go over this PowerPoint. And I'm just gonna summarize. I know that some of y'all said y'all get real tired real easy, so make sure we just quick point again. So the mission of our office is to make sure that we give you extra and co-curricular activities designed to help you in your academic life. You go next. The things that we do on campus, we do programs, workshops, events, leadership training. We have 35 organizations on campus, y'all. We don't do student IDs anymore. I've taken that off. Student IDs are now in the L building when you first enroll. We do student travel. We guarantee mentors and advisors and programs. Go ahead. These are some of the things that we do on campus. If you're on campus, you're going to want to do something. You're not going to sit around all day, right? If you're between classes, we sit in the courtyard and stare at each other. No, and guess what? Guess what my office also does for you? As college students, you're always what? Hungry? I will feed you. For free. The only thing you need to present to me is your student ID. Now, what do you have to have to get the food on the picture here? Keep going. We actually take students to the Capitol to meet your representatives. To talk about what? To talk about you. So please get involved. We have the new students that retire. We have a service learning program where you can get credit for doing volunteer work. Okay, we have internships. How many of y'all want to get a really good job when you graduate? All right, so you're going to need to have some internships. An externship means that they're like on financial aid here at the college, so we can actually send them out at the same time. Okay, so continue. All right, so basically, what we make sure that you do is to find your niche while you're here, get involved with the campus, and then go out and do your skills that you learned here at Cedar Valley College. Okay, so I do have some questions for you now that I'm talking about it. Oh, and one more thing we do for you. Not only will you get your transcript when you graduate, but my office will give you a co-curricular transcript. So when you do go for your job and you say, I was involved with something, you have proof that you actually did it. And let me tell you something. As a person who hires people, I want to know who fits in my job, not just that they had a 4.0, but I want to know what you did while you were in college. And trust me when I tell you, these co-curricular transcripts, which I've been telling you about, will help you get a job. Because I've had people call me and say, guess what? I got a job because I could prove that I did something when I was in college. And who doesn't want that, right? Better paying job. So I got a couple questions to ask you. How many clubs and organizations do we have on this campus?
35.
Okay. What do you need to have in free food? Well, so you don't get bored, but to become involved, right? Okay, so have I had an opportunity to send people out of the country?
Yes, I have.
So what do you want to do when you get to Cedar Valley College? You want to come find my office, right? My office is located the first floor, the whole first floor of D Building. It's the Office of Student Life area where we have a place for you to sit down and chat and a place for you and a rec room. Okay? So, one more time. What place do I get to take students? And where else? Out of the country. And where do I take my student government people?
Okay.
So I have three shirts here that I want to give away. And there are shirts that we have in our offices.
We have a little model here too.
If you can remember, when I got introduced, what is my name? What is the one thing that upsets me when I'm at graduation? There you go. Did you hear that? When somebody asked me about organizations that we already have. Okay? One more question. I'm looking at that back row over there to see if anybody can answer this question. Okay. Where am I located?
And
I'll tell you what, they do some of the most amazing programming. They're the top, they've been top in the nation and the world. Our chapter has been, well, it's not mine, I can't take credit for it. But it's an amazing program that if you have a 3.5 or better after your first 12 hours, you will be sent a letter saying you're eligible. But if you don't get that letter, if you have that, you come talk to us, we'll put you in contact. And those students are eligible for transfer scholarships to SMU and other places. So I just want you to really think about that and consider being an officer. You have five? We have five? All right. Oh, wait, raise your hand if you're already in Phi Theta. Woo! Okay. So our final speaker, and this is usually the one we get the most questions for, is our English coordinator, faculty extraordinaire, Rebecca Rios Harris.
All right, can everybody hear me back there? Great, back. I'm usually loud too. Neil, she and I were the same. But I want to welcome you. I appreciate you coming, and we do have a great investment in your students and your children, and we're glad that you're here. And all of you that are in here are part of that investment, parents, guardians, aunts, uncles, you name it, brothers, sisters. We're here for all of you, all right? We're a community, we're a family, so just remember that. Ms. Gara Long, I appreciate her mentioning Phi Theta Kappa. I'll start there really quickly. Phi Theta Kappa is our International Honor Society of the two-year college. It is elite, it is great, it is something that you want to strive to be a part of. We have a lot of fun, but I mean, it's a lot of work, yes, but it's a lot of fun, and it's a leadership growth experience. We actually have programs, we have events that all revolve around the theme every year. Every year we change the theme. The students get out there, and we have activities in the community, on campus, out in our region, and then we also have also traveled, and we've gone around the United States every year to different states. There are about 1,200 chapters in the world, and when we say world, we don't mean United States. We mean Guam, Germany, Laos. They're everywhere. They're all Arab Emirates. We have them everywhere. And out of the 1,300 chapters in the world, in about 2014, 2015, we were actually number one in the world right here at Cedar Valley.
The world.
Phi Theta Kappa. So we're very proud of that. Here are our officers for this year that just left us and graduated, except for one. But anyway, this was our team this year, and we're very proud of them. We've been in the top 25 for years and years. We actually got in the top 25 this year as well. So we're very, very proud of that. And we want you to be part of that. You can get scholarships based upon just membership. Just for them seeing stamped Phi Theta Kappa on your transcript, a lot of four-year schools will say, okay, I'll waive the application fee. All right, I have a $1,200 a semester scholarship I'll just give you because I see Phi Theta Kappa. Yeah. I mean, they'll do that big time. We do have graduates who have gotten full rides at Columbia, at TCU, UNT, UT, you name it, they've been there, SMU. So please, you know, don't let that go. If you see the letter come in the mail, a lot of people look at it, oh, I want a fraternity or a sorority. That's not what we are. We're an honor society. Again, Phi Theta Kappa means wisdom, aspiration, and purity. That's what we mean, and that's what we stand for. So if you have any other questions, you know, I'm here, and I will go into the, we already spoken. I have been into Carter, actually. I've been to your school several times this past semester. So we're going to make sure that we get everybody involved that needs to be involved. All right? All right. Oh, yeah, no problem. There you go. You can look that up there. All right, the other part, the academic side as well, that I'm representing, I am the English coordinator, and there are a lot of things that what we do in the English department kind of trickles on through all of your other courses and the other departments as well, so that's why I wanted to start with you. It's going to be easy to remember this because I've actually made my outline to begin with each of the letters of the word Carter, okay? C, communication, it is vital, you guys. You have to communicate. You need to communicate verbally through email. It has to be appropriate. It has to be clear. So make sure when you're in a college classroom, all of that makes sense. Make sure that you do that. It also needs to be immediate. Don't wait. I actually had a student that emailed me, no lie, this week, wondered about a grade from July 2017. Really? That's too late, okay? You have to, if you have a question, don't wait for the semester to end. Don't wait for the week to end. Ask the instructor right then. We are here to help you. I know it can be kind of intimidating sometimes. Well, I don't want to ask. That's what we're here for, you guys. Okay? Please do that. Also, just make sure your communication is appropriate in tone and in time. In other words, you don't want to interrupt the middle of a class lecture, right? Unless the instructor says you have questions. Wait till after class. We have a passing time. Wait until you'll set up an appointment with the instructor. We do have office hours. Adjuncts don't as much, but either way, set it up. Okay? Also, there's protocol. If you have an issue, a complaint, a problem, a concern, go to the instructor first. That is the first way. We do have college protocol. If you are not satisfied after speaking to the instructor, then you go to the coordinator. Of course, in English, that would be me. All right? Every department has a coordinator, and you go to that individual. And that's so we can sit there and help you every level. All right? Most of the time, it's handled with the instructor. It's done. So just make sure that you communicate. Also, if you're absent, communicate that to your instructors. It's like having a job. You wouldn't want to just not show up at a job and not let them know you're not going to be there. Because a job wouldn't be there much longer, right? So we just, it's an equal respect. Okay? A, adults. Just like Chief Williams said, we have to consider you as adults in the college classroom, regardless of your age. That means if you have something that you want to talk about, you can come talk to us. We cannot talk to your parents. We cannot email your parents. We cannot call the parents. However, if there is a waiver on file where the student gives permission to the parents to speak to us, then go for it. We can do it at that point. Please understand, we're kind of bound by law as well. Okay? So just make sure if you come up with your student, I did that this summer already. I've spoken to some people. They brought a parent, said, okay, look, I said, I can't speak. I give you permission. Okay, great, no problem then. A verbal permission was okay at that point as well. Okay? So just remember that. You are adults, so you are expected to act as such. I know it's hard when you're kind of in between, you know, but that's okay. Hey, you're given this opportunity. Take advantage of it. R, respect. Remember, of course, you give it to get it. And I know that doesn't always happen that way. We all know that, right? But at least if you do what you're supposed to do, you won't be in the wrong, right? So just make sure that you give that respect. Respect the rules and protocols of college. Respect the system. Respect the hallways, the common areas, like Vidya said, the library, the tutoring center, the labs, anywhere you go, there are rules for whether to be quiet or don't look at personal things on there. Use it for educational purposes only. And remember, especially the classroom, respect your professor, respect the other students in your classroom, respect yourself. Okay, and all that will work out. T, textbooks and materials. You need them in class all the time. That's a struggle. Students come to class, oh, I forgot my book, or I don't have a book, or wait, I don't have a disk to save my work on a computer. You know, we're in computer labs for a lot of classes. So make sure you have a disk to save all your work on. Okay? Make sure that you have the proper textbook, and make sure you read them and utilize them to your advantage. All right? E, of course, I put English. And the reason why is because we know that's the formal language here, right? And when you are in a class, especially an English class, you are expected to write in formal academic English. Please understand what that is. And that's even if you're writing a paper for speech class or government or history or biology, you're still required to write in formal English. That means be aware of your language. No text talk. That is huge right now. All of you know that. I tell my students, I can text talk with the best of you, probably go faster than you. But you know what? There's a time and a place. And school isn't the place. Okay? So make sure that you are writing your papers properly for any class. No slang. And the thing we've been having a lot of trouble with over the past couple of years has been plagiarism. Do you know what that is? Please, and I want parents, guardians, all of you need to be on board with this because we're having people, well, I didn't know that's plagiarism. That's not really plagiarism. If it's any idea, piece of information, even a picture that you got from somewhere else and did not give that person, place, or organization credit, it is plagiarism. It is illegal. Okay? You wouldn't want to take your time writing something, and I use it, and I get credit for it, when you spent 5 years writing that book. You know, that wouldn't be very fair. It's your book. You get the royalties, not me. So that's the thing. Please, plagiarism is big. Do your own, you know, do of course your own work. Don't copy other people's work, even your own classmates. People have gotten on now where they get on discussion boards and they copy people's responses and use it as their own. Don't do that. Okay? You're better than that. That's my point. All right? Also make sure that you look for grammar, punctuation, and everything in papers and in emails. I know in our English department, we have in all of our syllabi, we have an actual little phrase that says, if your emails are not written grammatically and mechanically correct, we will return it to you and ask you to correct it before we respond. So please make sure that you are even emailing appropriately. You guys, you need to do that for the real world anyway, right? So make sure that you know how to do that. R, responsibility. It is your responsibility to make sure you follow these things, okay? Take full responsibility for your own actions. No excuses. It's not, oh, well, somebody made me do. No. You are responsible, just like I am, for what I do and what I say, okay? Also, be proactive. Again, don't wait. If you have a confusion, a question, ask. What you put into a class is what you get out of it. Please don't forget that, okay? And just, like I said, we're here to support you, but please don't wait. And we're here, don't think nobody's here for you, because we are here to encourage you and back you up, all right? And I will, well, are there any questions, first and foremost, about Carter? Everybody's good, are you sure?
Can you give the acronym for those again?
Say it again?
The acronym for Carter, can you give?
Oh, sure, communication. Adults, respect, textbooks, and I put slash materials, but textbooks, English, and responsibility. Okay, are there any questions? Then I'll leave you with one last thing. And this also spells the C-A-R-T-E-R. With Cedar Valley, come and realize true educational remarkableness.
Okay, we stayed on time. So I want to give everybody a 5-minute chance to get up and stretch before we go on to the Carter transition part. If you have questions during that time, some of our speakers are still in the room, you can find them. If anyone needs to use the facilities, you go out to your right, and you'll see the sign out in the hallway. 5 minutes and then be back. 5 minutes. Bye. 5 minutes.
I need something to drink.
This thing.
Jackson, stay.